Let's take a look at this example. Both travel around a circular path with the radius of curvature of 40 meters. For the case that the path is a circular path, it means that the radius of curvature is the constant. It's constant. Okay? Because it is a circular path, the radius of curve is always constant. That is, so for this case, is equal to 40 meters. At a speed that increases with time. Speed is a function of time and defined by this. When speed is equal to 0.0625 t square meter per second. And we would like to determine the boat velocity and acceleration at the instant time equal to 10 seconds. Okay, so for velocity, we have the speed function already. And actually, we know that the velocity of the particles is always tangent to the path. It has just only one component. Okay, so but the acceleration is composed of two components, that is acceleration in tangential direction and acceleration in normal direction. Okay, so let's we start to determine this problem by starting with the velocity vector. As we know that the velocity vector is composed just only one component, that is the velocity is always tangent to the path. So it has just only one component. It's equal to the speed time ut. Ut is the tangential direction, okay? And the magnitude is given by this equation. This is the problem is given us like this. And then when time equal to 10 seconds, we substitute time into this equation, we obtain the speed equal to 6.25 meter per second. That is the first answer for the first problem. Okay, we would like to determine the speed. If we write it in vector, it should be like this: 6.25 ut. Okay, or you may use the notation like this: 6.25 t. That is it's maybe up to you. Okay. So this is the first one, and this is the magnitude. And when we would like to determine the acceleration vector, for acceleration vector is composed of two components, that is AT and AN, okay? In direction of tangential direction and normal direction, UT and UN. Tangential direction is equal to V dot. But normal direction is equal to V square over rho. So the tangential component of acceleration AT is equal to V dot. This is equal to the first derivative of velocity function. And we have we have acceleration in tangential direction is equal to 0.125 t meter per second squared. So then at time equal to 10 seconds, we have the tangential acceleration AT is equal to 1.25 meter per second squared. When we substitute time equal to 10 seconds into this equation. And then for normal components, normal component is equal to V squared over rho. For this problem, rho is constant because it is a circular path. This is equal to 40 meter, okay? And the velocity at that time, velocity at time equal to 10 seconds, we determine it already. It is equal to 6.25 meter per second. So then we substitute when time equal to 10 seconds, V equal to 6.25 into this equation, that is V square over rho, we obtain the acceleration in normal component, equal to 0.9766 meter per second square. And then the magnitude of the acceleration is equal to 1.59 meter per second square. Let's complete this problem. And then we moving to next problem, that is the motion is moving along the curve path that is defined by this equation. And we will see that this path is not the circular path like the previous problem. So then it means that the radius of curvature at any point along the path is maybe not constant. Okay, that's we have to determine. Okay, so for this problem, a roller coaster travel along a vertical parabolic path defined by the equation y equal to 0.01 x squared. At point B, it had a speed of, we know that at point B, we have VB is equal to 25 meter per second. And with this increasing at the rate of 3 meter per second square. Okay. Increasing at the rate of mean that velocity is increased at the rate of 3 meter per second square. This term represents the acceleration in tangential component that is equal to 3 meter per second square. As you same as when you drive the car along the curve path and you increase the speed of the car, okay, so then this the increasing in speed of the car that you drive is mean that you increase the tangential acceleration. Okay, you cannot increase the normal acceleration, you increase just only the tangential acceleration because you drive the car, okay, and the car travel along the curve path, and the velocity of the car, the directions of the car, you hold it to the path that is always tangent to the path. So then, when you increase the speed, it should be along the tangent direction, okay. So then, the wording in the problem that increase the rate of velocity. It means the tangential acceleration. And we would like to find the magnitude of roller coaster acceleration when time is at point B. Okay. So the magnitude of roller coaster acceleration is mean that is combined between tangential acceleration that we already know and another acceleration component that is time form the change in direction. That is we have to find, that is AN. Okay, we have to find AN first. And after that, we can determine the total magnitude of the acceleration that is composed of tangential acceleration and normal acceleration. Okay. So for this problem, the tangential components of acceleration is the rate of change in roller coaster speed, that is V dot. And the problem is given us already, it is equal to 3 meter per second square. And then when we would like to determine the normal acceleration AN at that point, at any point, we have to determine from V over rho. Okay, but for this problem, rho is equal to what? We don't know. But from the formula that, from the calculus, we know that the radius of curvature can determine by this formula if we know the path, if we know the path function y. Okay. For this case, we know the path function as the problem defined. The path function is defined by y equal to x squared over 100. So according to this, we can determine each term. That is, the first one is divided by the x is become 0.0 to x, and then we take the second derivative to y with respect to x again. We obtain the constant 0.02. And then we substitute this value into this formula. When x equal to 30 meter, okay? When x equal to 30 meter, it means that dy by the x is equal to 0.02x. That becomes 0.6. And d2y by the x2 is become this value. Substitute this value into this formula. We obtain this. And we found that the radius of curvature at this point is equal to 79.3 meter. So then the normal components of acceleration is v square over rho. For this case, v at this point is given by the problem, which is equal to 25 meter per second. Okay, and rho we already determined is equal to 79.3. So then we can determine an, that is the normal acceleration, is equal to v square over rho, and we get normal acceleration is 7.881 meter per second squared. And its magnitude of acceleration, this is composed of two components, AT and AN, is become 8.43 meter per second squared. That completes this problem.